Aquarius, this is your reading. It's a love reading for the remainder of the month, for the 24th through the 31st. For Aquarius, in love. Let's see what messages we get for you guys. What messages do we have for Aquarius in love? Messages for Aquarius. We have the Chariot there. Cancer energy. This is about moving forward successfully and really being sure of yourself. This is also about having a successful relationship here. So I feel like that has been the focus and is probably still the focus for you guys. It's being successful in love. Just be that. Then we have the Nine of Cups. For some of you, this is like strictly your journey without someone else. It's about what makes you happy. For those of you who this is a relationship that is involved in this, that you're concerned about, this is about you being successful and happy, but it has to be something that kind of like it jives with you, it vibes with you, putting yourselves first. And of course, that is so important that you put yourself first and not to be selfish, like, and disregard other people, but to make sure you're not putting yourself on the back burner. And I see you guys are looking at things in like the right way, okay? This Piscean energy here. Being in your feelings for some of you. Then we have the Sun there. This Leo energy, that fixed energy. That's at the center of your reading there. It's about being happy. It's about being enlightened. Recognizing things for the way that they really are. Seeing things for what they really are, okay? This is also about ego being involved. What else do we have for Aquarius? We have the Ace of Swords there. I feel like some of you have come to the realization about what it takes to make you happy, what you need to do to make you happy, because the Ace of Swords and the Sun is like this revelation, and it's not something that you have relied on others for. This is something that you have sought inside of yourselves here. Okay, the Ace of Swords is always like, you know, coming up with something on your own, or going by the experiences that you've had, you know, just taking out of those experiences what, you know, you need to in order to gain the knowledge and the wisdom that you need, right? And then we have the Eight of Coins. And this is about building, working together, or working by yourself, working on yourself, doing whatever it takes, but working really hard and diligently to obtain those things that you want. For some of you, this is not just about a relationship. This is also about your finances here, okay? Your livelihood and being successful, being happy, being acknowledged, okay? Gaining the wisdom that you need to move through this life successfully. And the Two of Swords is here under the Chariot. I feel like there's something that you guys are not really seeing. It's like having blinders on, though. There's something that's getting in the way of your success. Let's see. That's that Libra energy. And then we have the Page of Swords. You know, with the Page of Swords showing up next to the Two of Swords, it makes me feel like there's something that you're holding back, because a Page of Swords is not a speaker. The Page of Swords is more of an observer. So I feel like there's something that you need to speak on as far as like what makes you happy. Some of you are holding your tongue when you need to be speaking out. If this is a relationship, for it to truly be successful, I feel like do not hold your tongue. Speak your piece. Say whatever it is that you feel like you need to say, you know, and not to hurt someone else, or not to be like overbearing or boisterous or what have you, but just to speak your peace, be honest with yourself and others about what you need to be happy. Okay. And then we have the Knight of Swords here. I mean, the Knight of Coins. So this is a coin. And so is the Eight of Coins. So there's something I feel that's dealing with your finances as well. Planning and nurturing something, not moving too fast, making some movement, but not getting ahead of yourself. Okay? Not thinking ahead of yourself, not talking yourselves out of something. Because I see that, you know, you guys are probably not conversing with anybody about your situation, but there's a lot of things that you try to work out within yourself. So this is for you not to get ahead of yourself and not to talk yourselves out of your happiness. Or to think that you can just do it all by yourself. Sometimes you have to vocalize things, right? Okay, that's that Taurus energy there with the Knight of Coin. I feel like this level of stubbornness here. And then we have the Nine of Wands here. This is feeling tired. Okay, this is having gone through a battle, having gone through a struggle. So I do feel like, you know, right now, because this is at the center of your reading with the Sun and the Knight of Coins, this is making plans for your happiness, moving sort of methodically and having to plan your steps, doing what you feel like is necessary for you to do, for you to say, and to move in that direction. If that entails allowing someone else to know your plan, then that's probably what you need to do. But there's definitely something here that you are not seeing. But over here, this is taking some knowledge that you feel like you know. This is like an aha moment. This is like revelation. Okay, this is like an aha moment where, you know, you've been tired thus far, you've been beat down thus far, and kind of wanting to give up on something. But this Nine of Wands tells me that you still have it in you to move forward. It's something that you actually want to do, to move forward. You know it's going to be hard work here with this Eight of Coins, but I still see you guys wanting to move forward, but I feel like you need to, like, speak your mind, speak your peace, you know, say what it is that you want in this relationship, because there's somebody I feel like that's here that you're kind of holding your tongue with, and maybe that's to not, like, rock the boat or something, but, yeah. There's something going on here where I feel like you guys are being quiet and not truly speaking what's on your heart, okay? This takes hard work. It definitely takes hard work. And then we have the Eight of Cups here, which is Piscean energy. If this is coming back to the Nine of Wands, you have the Eight of Cups, the Nine of Wands, and you have the Nine of Cups. This is about you getting yourself together first, realizing what it takes to make you happy first and foremost before you can be happy with someone else, right? So the Eight of Cups is actually coming back to the Nine of Wands, realizing that, yeah, it's been tough so far, but not really giving up on what it is that you want, right?
So the Eight of Cups coming back in is actually symbolizing that you guys have had this aha moment and you've been weighed down on something and possibly wanting to give up on it. But coming back to it, it's like, okay, I'm not completely ready to just throw in the towel. I know this is going to take some hard work, but I'm in for it. I'm up for it here. Okay, so that is what I have for you guys. I think I told you the signs here. Libra is here, but I feel like this is like your energy, okay? Because it's all about you getting to a place where you can be open and honest, not only with yourself, but with others as well, okay? So I'll be talking with you guys soon.